Hello everyone and welcome to this video, and today I'm going to take a look at this album here. It's by Aztec Camera and it's their album Knife. So yes, I'll just be doing the usual thing in this video, giving a bit of background information about the album, then show you my vinyl copy of it, plus a couple of other tidbits I've got, and then I will look at each of the album songs in detail. So this was, as I said, the band's second studio album, released on the 21st of September in 1984. Since the success of their first album, Highland Hard Rain, the band had left the label Rough Trade and had signed with the major label WEA Records. So having a major label behind the band allowed them to use a state-of-the-art recording studio, in this case Air Studios in London, which was owned by George Martin, as well as working with a big name in the music industry, like who produced the album, like in this case like Mark Knopfler from Dire Straits. Like, notably, this was only his second production credit, like, for another artist, like his first one being Bob Dylan's Infidels album. So like, certainly like for like, kind of like an indie kind of band like Aztec Camera, to get him like working with them like was quite something. And then also like their sound largely changed as well. They replaced the largely acoustic sounds of Highland Hard Rain with more like electric guitars and also a lot more synthesizers on this album. Also, around this time, the band lineup changed. Well, like, I must admit, I mean, like, Aztec Camera's lineup was always changing. They really were more just like a vehicle, like, for like Roddy Frame's like songs. But like in like this era, like a second guitarist joined the band, a guy called Malcolm Ross, who was a former member of the bands Joseph K and Orange Juice. So he further enhanced their sound. So upon its release, it did do quite well. It reached number 14 in the UK albums charts, higher than Highland Hard Rain. However, the critical reception was a lot more muted, with some not appreciating the band's heavier use of synthesizers, and also like in like the music press as well, Mark Knopfler wasn't a really like a credible like sort of like name, like hardly like a well-liked figure, so that like was stacked against the album too. But before I show you my vinyl copy of it, I have got a couple of little tidbits to show. So first one is the tour programme from the tour. Now, no, I didn't get to go and see them like in 1984. This is my uncle's like tour programme, because this was his original album. So it's quite cool that like he's got this as well. It's just a bit of a write-up like about the band there. And then there's goes through each of the members. So there's Roddy Frame. You've got Malcolm Ross, who was, as I said, the second guitarist. David Ruffy, who plays drums with the band. Yes, I had to check that there. And then a nice live shot of them performing. Are we summary of all their releases like up to this point as well, which is quite nice. Is there any more in here? Yeah, just like the other members. So the bass player and I believe the keyboardist there. Very nice. And then the last page, just a nice picture of the band there. So that is the tour program from the Knife tour there, of 1984. So that's really cool. And they've also got this, which is kind of like a live EP, which I'm not sure what this is officially called, but it's just it's quite a cool like little thing. It's like a sort of like a landscape like sort of thing, and it opens up like so quite unique. And then in here there's a 10-inch record which has a couple of live tracks, I believe, on it. Again, I'm just trying to see if this is, yeah, if there's no insert or anything, but that's what it looks like there. And then there's five tracks on here. So I'm not sure like how rare this is, but yeah, you've got the Bugle Sounds Again, Mattress of Wire, The Birth of the Truth, and then on the other side is Backwards and Forwards, and their version of Jump, originally done by Van Halen there. So yeah, a really nice little like EP there. Okay, and I'll go over the actual vinyl album here. So yeah, I'm not big on this cover personally. I don't think it's quite as good as Highland Hard Rain. It's just a bit, yeah, just doesn't really stand out for me too much. There's the back of it there. And then you've got the inner sleeve, which just has the lyrics on it. And again, some band shots, I think, looks like the same ones from the tour programme. And the record itself, as I said, is on WEA, but a kind of like a sort of nice sort of custom label there. So yeah, that is the vinyl record looked at. Okay, so I now go over each of the album songs. So there's only 9 tracks here, so it might be quite a quick review this. But yeah, I'll just go through each of those songs and score each track, which will give us a overall percentage marking for the album. So the album kicks off with a song, Still on Fire, which is a really fun, upbeat song to kick off the album. It's very poppy sounding, it does have a slightly dated feel to it, but it's a fun track though, which I must say, I am surprised wasn't a hit single. But it's got a really catchy riff, it's kind of got like a sort of like a, it's got like a duel between like the electric and the acoustic guitar, which sounds really great. Just all kind of production on it, it is very crisp, but also yeah, it is quite a commercial sound to it, definitely a fuller sound than there was on Highland Hard Rain. But like as it was, this single was a big flop, only reached number 83, but I think it should have done a whole lot better because it is a really fantastic song, and yeah, I think a great way to kick off the album. Next track up is called Just Like the USA, which is a song which builds up really well. It kind of starts with really just like Roddy Frame's vocal and a kind of background organ, but then more guitars come in, the drums come in, and yeah, it just sort of picks up the track really well. Got some really great guitar licks on it. I think it's Malcolm Ross playing it, and he's just all over this song really. And I think it's quite a memorable song. It's sort of like a toe-tapping track. It's a really nice song there. So for me, that one would get a 9 out of 10. Next track is called Head Is Happy, Heart's Insane, which is a kind of ballad this one. It's a much kind of slower, kind of softer song, for Aztec Camera. Kind of starts off with this sort of kind of sparkly sounding piano, and then you've got some brass embellishments on it as well. Roddy Frame sings the song quite well. I mean, he's certainly not the best singer like in the world. He's not got like the biggest range sort of thing, but when he sings it, he has got quite a pleasing, quite a reassuring kind of voice, I think. And like, I think like he croons the song quite well. And lyrically, it's quite a good track. It's about someone who is sort of confused, like about like their feelings. He sings on it, since I'm scattered and deranged, I shall seek your holy lunacy. Laugh with joy and laugh with pain. So quite deep lyrics there, and I do like the song. So yeah, for me, we'll get an 8 out of 10. Nesha Cop, which closes the first side, is The Back Door to Heaven, it's called, which is definitely for me the most synth-heavy song on the album. It's probably the one which is dated the most, I would say. But I do like the song though. I think there's still a lot of muscle like on the song though, especially on kind of the verses and like the instrumental bits of it. You've kind of got like, again, like a sort of duel between like the electric guitar and then also like more of like the kind of synthesizers going on like in it. I do like the song. I think it's kind of got a kind of Bob Dylan-esque sort of feel like in place, especially when Frame sings that line like, will we swap ourselves like children for the value of our innocence. He really just sort of spits that line out, just like I think Bob Dylan would do, like if like, he was singing this song. So yeah, overall, it is a song which I do enjoy, but yeah, it is maybe like one of the more like dated songs on the album, production wise, I would say. I wish myself into your arms. Next track up is called All I Need Is Everything, which is a slightly longer song. This one maybe goes on for about 5 or 6 minutes, and it's definitely longer than what we've been used to with Aztec Camera. Usually their songs are quite short, like, and to the point. But I do think this song does work, despite its length, and it also works through its length, like, as well. It's kind of got a great kind of, like, a kind of Mariba sort of synth texture on it going through the track. Plus, these really sort of jangly guitars, like, on it as well, like, which, again, run through the track. And, like, yeah, like, they give it that sort of, like, that indie sort of, like, flavour to it, like, which I do like. Plus, then it's also got this kind of danceable kind of thing going on, like, as well, like, with the synths. I just think it is a melding, like, of different styles, this song, and I think it works really well. Again, it was a single, but not a big one. It reached only number 34 on the UK charts. I mean, I certainly think it had potential to be a much bigger single. Ooh, backwards and forwards. special cop is called Backwards and Forwards, which is for me maybe my least favourite on the album. I'd say it's my least favourite because I think it's the most bland and the most forgettable song on the album. I mean, plus side on it, there are some nice Spanish guitar playing going throughout the track. I mean, it's a perfectly pleasant song, but yeah, it's just very forgettable, and it just doesn't excite me, kind of like the melody of it. There's just nothing, yeah, it's just filler for me, like, on the album, unfortunately. Which I said, like, is unfortunate. I mean, considering, like, there is only 8 tracks here, so, like, not a lot of space, like, for, like, a slightly lesser song like this to hide. But anyway, yeah, 6 out of 10 there for Backwards and Forwards.
Sometimes I get down, but it's not you that...
And the next track up is called The Birth of the Truth, which is a kind of solo Roddy Frame acoustic track. This, like, it really just strips down all the sound, all the production on this, and it is just Roddy Frame, like, kind of guitar. Very similar kind of in style to Down the Dip from Highland Hard Rain. But this song has got a really great melody on it. Like, I really like the bit, like the pre-chorus bit, like, there's sometimes I get down, but it's not you that gets me down. It's just that sense of the impossible. That just really, really rolls off his tongue, like, really well. In many ways, though, the song doesn't fit in with the rest of the album because it is... because it is more like in line, like, with, like, the material on their debut, but on the other hand, I do think it is a good break from the very glossy production numbers, like, which are also on the album. So I think it works really well, and I would give The Birth of the Truth an 8 out of 10 there.
Oh, it's twists are cruel and hopeless.
And then we finish the album with the sort of, I would say, the kind of the centerpiece of title track, Knife, which is, for me, maybe the only song where you can, kind of listening to it, sort of think, I wonder if Mark Knopfler's been involved with this track, because it has this kind of trademark sort of guitar tone on it, this sort of distorted but kind of smooth sort of sound I got, like, at the same time. I mean, like, I'm not sure if it's Knopfler playing it, but, like, it really wouldn't surprise me, like, if it is, because it just sounds like a Dire Straits song, this. And it is a very long song to it. Goes on for about 9 minutes, this one. I mean, it is very atmospheric. It is very different. And I do appreciate, like, Aztec Camera trying something a bit different, sort of pushing the boat out, like, a little bit, like, with this song. And I think the space, to an extent, works. I mean, yes, it is 9 minutes, but I do think, like, having, like, sort of, like, these sort of sections where there's no drums on it and it's just guitar, yeah, it gives the track a lot of space for that guitar. And then Roddy Frame's vocal is really great, really kind of emotional sort of vocal from him, and quite bleak lyrics on it. He sings, like, and the knife has got my number, and the number that you keep, the knife is called division, and it's drawn when I'm asleep. And so, yeah, I mean, lyrically, it's a very good song. But, I mean, at 9 minutes, it is a bit drawn out, I would say. And it's kind of got this sort of, again, it's got a bit of a bass solo on it, which I don't think is really needed. And it is just a bit of a, I guess, a bit of a downer, like, off, like, an ending, kind of, like, it's one of these songs that where you're kind of thinking, oh, when's this going to be over? That kind of thing. But for the most part, it's still good. Yeah, it is still a good song. Yeah, probably I'm a bit conflicted, like, with this track, because I do like it, but it's just maybe a bit too much of it. So, yeah, Knife, for me, overall, would get an 8 out of 10. Okay, so overall, this album would score 84%, which is still a very good score, but it's, for me, not quite as strong as the debut album, which, if my memory serves when I reviewed that, must have scored at least 88% and maybe even 90%. I mean, this is still a fine album. There's no really weak moments on here. There's no tracks, like, which are terrible or bad. It's just maybe gets a bit samey, like, in places. But there are still a lot of good qualities about it. I think it retains the kind of great guitar playing, like what, like, Roddy Frame showed, like, on Highland Hard Rain, but sort of, like, fleshed out, like, a little bit more, like, on here. And it's kind of, yeah, it's a more gentler, more sort of mellow kind of feel to the album. But then also a development in terms of their sound, going for a more atmospheric and, I guess, a, yeah, like, more sort of mellow feel. And the production as well doesn't really bother me, like, on this album. I know that that was what I was criticised for a lot, like, at the time. And it's certainly not the disaster what, like, a lot of people, like, wanted to paint it as, like, at, like, the time. Sort of, like, this, like, really weak, like, sort of, like, unworthy follow-up. I don't think it sounds too dated, really. Certainly compared to, like, the follow-up album to this, Love, which sounds absolutely... I'm not a fan of that album personally. It's really very 80s, that album. This one I think holds up a lot better. I think the song quality is stronger, and it's just another really good album, like, from Aztec Camera here. I mean, he was still only 20 when he made this album, that Roddy Frame. Absolutely fantastic songs here. So that's been my review of Aztec Camera's Knife. So I hope you have enjoyed the video, and I will see you all next time for the next one. Goodbye.